And the formula seems nice and seems to be long. English is hard sometimes. Okay, what was I saying? It's long wearing. That's what I was trying to say before. My brain, it's a struggle most days. Hi everyone, it's me, Ray Ray, again. Welcome back to my channel. Thank you so much for joining me once again. Today I thought I would just come on and share some of my favorite luxury products that I have been enjoying. I don't have a ton to talk about because, to be quite honest, I have been using drugstore stuff more than I have been using like luxury makeup skincare recently. I definitely use more of the luxury stuff when I do skincare rather than makeup, but I definitely still have some favorite makeup stuff that is a little bit more higher price point. I also have a couple of fragrances that I really like as well. I would like to get more into fragrance, honestly, but like that's expensive, you know, it's a little expensive. Can't be buying too many fragrances and then they last like a really long time. I don't really wear them every single day, so I guess like I don't have the biggest reason to buy them. But anyways, I might as well just go ahead and kind of get right to it. And yeah, let's go ahead and get going, shall we? All right, so to get started, we'll go ahead and talk about a couple of skincare items that I've been enjoying. So the first one I will show you is this. So the Watermelon Glow PHA BHA Pore Tight Toner from Glow Recipe. Honestly, all Glow Recipe products are awesome. I have probably bought probably 5 bottles of this over the time that I've been using it. So I have bought quite a bit of this and I really, really like it. It is sort of like this really cool milky texture. It's thick, it's moisturizing, but it also helps with exfoliation, which my skin is quite prone to breakouts. Case in point there, if you can see that. So I totally picked at that one and totally made it worse, you know, as one does. So this definitely helps with the exfoliation side of all of that. And I think that it's good to have a toner that is also an exfoliant. That should be the toner step ideally. So at least at night. I like to do this at night primarily. I don't really do it during the day. I actually have a toner for the day and it is also Glow Recipe. So this one, oh gosh, I did not realize how little I have left of this. It's only about this much left. So I've been using this pretty much every single day before my makeup. So this is, of course, also from Glow Recipe, the Cloudberry Bright Essence Toner. This has the CoQ10 in it, which is supposed to be like an antioxidant. So it's supposed to help fight free radical damage. And pairing that alongside of your sunscreen during the day is supposed to sort of help give you more of a, you know, like more defense against all the badness in the world for your face, you know. Anyways, I'm 30, like I'm trying to consider anti-aging a little bit, you know. I feel like time for me to definitely consider that. So I wanted to grab a hold of this and I'm not disappointed. I will say, in comparison to the Watermelon Glow one, it is a lot more liquidy. So with the watermelon glow one, I put that on my hands and kind of rub it and put it on my face. But this one I will use on a cotton pad typically instead of just on my hands, but you can use it on your hands. It just seems to like it, you know, it drips, it's drippy, very drippy. So it's not as viscous as the watermelon glow one. So next on to another glow recipe product that I've been enjoying, and I just picked this up from the Sephora sale. So this is their new one, their niacinamide hue drops in the sun glow. So a little bit of some like little bronzy drops from Glow Recipe. I use the other ones, the regular ones that don't have the tint, the niacinamide, I guess they call them glow drops. They're not hue drops instead, because, well, they're clear. There is no hue to them, they are clear. And so I figured I would go ahead and like try this one out. And actually I did use it today. So today on my face, I have a couple of products that I will be talking about, but one I'm not going to talk about because I would talk about it. It's a nice product. I'm just not like in love with it, I guess, mostly because it's the wrong shade. It's the House Labs foundation. And it is way too pale for me, because that's what you get when you order stuff online and you can't actually swatch it and see what the color of it is. So it's way too pale for me. And so I thought, what if I had a kind of darker primer to go underneath of that? And I think it worked pretty well. I just used that foundation on top of those glow drops. And I think that it did help with the tone a bit and like kind of warm things up a bit, but I still wound up layering other stuff on top of the House Labs foundation. So, that way it wouldn't be so pale, but also it doesn't have that much coverage. It's not a full coverage foundation. It's like a medium coverage foundation. And so because of that and all of my redness, I just took like extra concealer and put that over the redness. So anyways, I would say if you have a really pale foundation, that those work nice as a base for like a pale foundation, because it kind of just like warms it up a bit. So I really appreciate it for that. Also, I like the feeling of it, and the color is actually quite nice, and it's not too pigmented, which is really nice, because as somebody who is extremely pale, stuff like that will look like garbage on me. It will look stupid and weird, and I'm not trying to look like Donald Trump. So
the light's no good. I always look orange.
Anyways, on to another skincare item. This will be the last one that I will talk about today. So this right here, this is the Skin Fix Barrier Plus Triple Lipid Peptide Cream. This stuff is awesome for a cream moisturizer that is, you know, it is somewhat heavy, which I like nowadays. I wouldn't have liked it back in the day, but now that I live like in a drier climate, I really need this sort of cream to actually like fight the damage that the wintertime does to my face. And especially now that I guess like getting older and being out of my 20s. Oh no. Now that I'm out of my 20s, my skin is like changing, which is very interesting. It is so much more dry than it ever used to be, but yet still annoyingly oily. Still, it will never not be oily, I guess, which is fine. I suppose that supposedly that helps with like wrinkles and stuff like that, but it just eats my makeup. So makes makeup really challenging, whatever. Anyways, I digress, but this stuff is excellent if you have like chronic dry skin and you just need something that is actually going to help with that. This is interesting for a couple reasons though too. So one, it has this kind of interesting pump. Well, I don't know. I don't actually know how I feel about the pump. It does get kind of dirty easily. So I don't know, like that's kind of annoying, but I do like you push down, it does dispense like a little dollop, and then it seems like it's actually like the right amount for my face, which I appreciate. But I don't think I love it as much as like a normal pump. I think I would prefer that. I do think it's nice that it does dispense like an appropriate amount. Also, this is kind of neat, and I think more brands should do this, but it is refillable. So there it is, there's the refill bit. So you can just easily put in another little container. Ah, well, maybe not super easy. Super easily. Kind of fell out a bit, but that's okay. We got it back. So you can get a refill, and it's a little bit cheaper than it normally. I just appreciate that you can just get something with less packaging. So definitely something that I'm trying to be aware of. That is so hard, and I'm not gonna get to a rant on that. I'm not gonna like rant about packaging on everything. That's like the worst though. I mean, like the wastefulness of everything is just, it just hurts so much. So it's actually refillable. I like that they give you that option. I approve Skin Fix. Thank you. Now, I guess we'll talk, before I get into the makeup, I might as well just talk about the fragrances that I really like. I'm gonna wipe it off because it's like a little dusty just on top. So the first one is this Kaoli Eden fragrance. So it is a sweet apple fragrance. So the keynotes, juicy red apple, who would have guessed that? Wild berries and jasmine. They say it's a fruity floral. Yeah, I mean, I really enjoy the fruitiness of it. I like that it is very much like a rich apple fragrance, but it's not like so apple that it's like, did you just like rub an apple on you? I suppose that would be weird, but it does smell very reminiscent of like an apple, but like a cool fragranced apple. I'm not a fragrance connoisseur. I don't know how to describe fragrances. I'm not a fragrance expert. I never will be. I would never describe myself as such. So my descriptions are very bad, and I'm very sorry that they are so bad. They're not very eloquent with my fragrance talk. I'm very sorry. So anyways, this is definitely one of my favorites. And you know, I've had it for quite some time, but gosh, look how much is still left, you know? So there's a decent amount there. I really don't spray a lot, just like little here. I like to put it in my hair because I feel like I can smell it for longer, and on my clothes too, so. But I will say the one negative about it is that it doesn't seem to last as long as I would like. It definitely does vanish quite quickly. That's kind of unfortunate, but like it does smell immediately really, really nice. On to the last fragrance that I have. This is the Replica by the Fireplace fragrance. So Mason Margiela. The keynotes are clove oil, chestnut accord, and vanilla accord. And it is warm and spicy. So I think this smells like so interesting in like the best way. It does smell like a fireplace, like you've been hanging out by the fireplace, but like a fireplace in a really nice smelling home that like only has like a little bit of the fireplace smell. It's like it's a little sprinkle, you know? So it does like have like that burnt wood smell to it, but it doesn't smell like obviously it doesn't smell like a fireplace. Like who would buy that? You just smell like burnt wood, you know? And like how after you're like sitting by a campfire for several hours, that smell just lingers on your hair and everything. It's just not the most, in my opinion, the most pleasant fragrance. This smells like that if you also smelled like a little bit like vanilla, I guess, too. So it's very warm. It's very sensual. It's very cozy. Extremely cozy. I usually only wear it in the wintertime because that is sort of the mood that I'm in. It's not really like a summer fragrance, you know, to me. Like it is just very warm. So it's just reminiscent of that. And I feel like this brand, Replica, is correct with its name. It is truly replicating your like memories, basically, is like the whole brand. It's supposed to replicate memories and kind of bring you back to these situations that you know and love, and it stimulates the brain with like memories. So it's pretty cool. Onto the makeup products. So let's get started. We'll go by brand here, I suppose. So, and I apologize, it is a little bit dirty because a lot of these packages, they get dirty so easily. So anyways, I'm sorry about that. Please forgive the dirtiness of my products. I tend to use them and then they tend to get dirty. So the first thing is this Natasha Denona, the My Dream palette. I'm gonna open this up. It's gonna be dirty. I'm very sorry, but there it is. These colors are some of my favorites for every day because they're very like neutral and they're more warm toned, which is kind of what I wear generally. And also some pinks and purples, some golds, that sort of thing. So the color story in this is definitely one of my favorites of all of the palettes that I have. So I use it quite a bit. There's some really cool colors in here too. One called Vision. I should have swatched it in a different spot. Okay. Yeah, okay, so now you can see it. So we got a pink to green shift there, so that one's pretty neat. And it is very silky and smooth. And then this one, the Invention, is kind of neat. Another sort of little bit shifty as well. So that's what that one looks like. So some really pretty shimmers, some really nice mattes. I use them quite a bit. Yeah, I actually probably use the mattes in this palette more than I do like maybe any other palette that I have. So this one gets a lot of love and definitely worth, I think it's like $65, I wanna say. So it's worth that price tag. Oh my gosh, this is about empty. I would buy another one. I just have a lot of concealers that I sort of need to go through. This is a really
stinking nice concealer. So this is the Natasha Denona, the High Glam Concealer. This is the shade N1. It is basically my skin tone. It is not really a concealer that I can use to highlight because it is just my skin tone. So I actually use it to compensate for other foundations. So on my like rosacea to cover up the redness. And I actually used it today on my cheeks just to cover up any extra redness that was still peeking through from the House Labs foundation. What I like about this is that it is super creamy, super moisturizing, super blendable. The formula is like it's pretty sweet. And it is very full coverage, but the texture is just the most ideal for a concealer. I am going to maybe try at some point a lighter shade, if they have a lighter shade that would work. I think they do. I just picked this one up because I thought that it would be light enough, but I mean, it is for my face normally, but it is not light enough for using under the eyes. So at some point I will pick up another shade and try that out for under the eyes. But until then, I'm gonna try to like scrape as much as I possibly can out from this tube because it is getting like really empty and it's getting really hard to actually get something on the applicator. So now I'll go to another brand that I have a couple of products from. I have talked about this one briefly, but this is, so the Hourglass, it's the Veiled Translucent Setting Powder. It is my favorite setting powder of life. I love it so much. It is the perfect setting powder. Okay, so the color is perfect. It isn't like so translucent that it's like white and leaves a weird white cast over the face. It has a nice color to it, but the color is just enough that it doesn't darken my highlighted areas, so like under the eyes. I still want those to be bright, right? And sometimes some translucent powders, for example, the Laura Mercier translucent powder is too dark for me. And so it ruins all the work for under my eyes. So it totally like makes that darker. It doesn't keep the brightness. But this does keep the brightness. And that's what I want. But not only that, it's soft. It is like a veil, right? The name does not lie. It is so good. And I will buy it till the end of time because I mean, I don't know of another setting powder that I like better than this. I really don't. Seriously, don't know. Haven't found one yet. And I have tried lots of setting powders and they're all just okay. But this one. Telling you, buy it. You won't regret it. And one more Hourglass product. This is, I wanna say, like, I don't think they always have this in their collection. I think it's really a Christmas time thing, but it comes around every year, so I'm not worried about recommending this because they usually put out something every year, and sometimes they even just have it still available. So this is the Ambient Lighting palette. Ambient Lighting Edit unlocked the butterfly one, which is like for super pale people like me. And also, sorry, it is dirty. I use it a lot, but there is the color palette. So you have a couple of blushes, a couple of like highlighters, and then a couple of ambient lighting setting powders, which are, if you don't know, if you're not familiar with the Hourglass powders, they have a little bit of kind of shimmer to them, but it's not so shimmery that it's actually like a highlighter. So that I actually like really love those setting powders. Those are also awesome. So instead of just the loose setting powder, I also use those ambient lighting powders too to set the face and kind of bring back a little bit of like a sheen to it too. So I also really love, well, everything that's in there. The blushes are awesome. I'm wearing that today as my blush. It's just kind of a nice, like, sort of mauve color. And then the highlighters are also really, really nice. So that's it for the Hourglass products. Now I'm gonna move on to just a few other brands. So be right back. So I don't have a ton of products left to chat about, but first I will kind of clean this off. This gets so dirty. all of these get so dirty. The packaging's so pretty and so shiny and nice, but I guess the downside is that it gets fingerprinty and looks pretty gross. So anyways, sorry that it's gross. But I guess we'll show you what this is. So I used this in my Star Chart makeup video. This is the Patrick Ta, the Double Take Cream and Powder Blush in She's a Doll. This stuff is, it's a lot. It's a lot of color. It's a lot of color. That's what that looks like. So this like pink blush, holy cow. Okay, like it's so much. I wanted a like bubblegum pink blush, which is why I went with this shade. I like it, but it's kind of too much. So you have to like really be careful with the powder. The cream though is definitely the part that I like the best with it. So like that's, you see that? Here, I'll put it on my hand. It's, yeah, there we go. So there we go. That one I feel like blends out maybe a little bit better. And I really like the texture of the cream blush. And I like that it's maybe easier to control a bit. So the powder isn't necessarily like my absolute favorite blush, like powder blush, but the cream is like one of my favorite cream blushes that I have. And so I would actually really enjoy to try other colors, or maybe like the bronzer one that they have. I would like to try that too. I do really like the formula overall. I think it's really nice, and also the packaging is quite adorable, aside from the fact that it gets dirty really quickly. But what are you gonna do when it looks all shiny and nice like that? There's just no avoiding it. So how it goes, how the cookie crumbles, I suppose. Another thing that I've been really enjoying is this little pencil. So this is the Tarte, the Fake Awake. And I think, well, it's like it's a nude shade. I don't know if it actually says on here. Well, I'll put it on the screen if there is actually a shade, or it'll be in the description box down below. I like this as, you know, a tight line on the bottom of my eyes just to sort of open up my eyes a bit. So I did actually use it today. And I really like the effect that it gives instead of like a white eyeliner, which I was using before, and that like works okay, but I do feel like a nude color definitely works better than that. And I like this formula. I think it glides on really nice. I guess the one thing I would say though is that I'm sort of over this brand. I'm sort of over this brand, if I'm quite honest. I was trying to see if I could find something else that would work better, but I did really like the color of this, and I like that it's a retractable pencil, which I just like better. I prefer that. I don't really like sharpening pencils very much. So I like that it's retractable, and I like the color. So I'm just tired of this brand. I feel like Tarte needs to work on some of their stuff, like the brand trip BS. Like, I understand it, but also at the same time, like, you could do something else, maybe. I think at this point we're all tired of like rich people doing rich people things. I don't know. It's just not my favorite brand, I guess. With that being said, I will talk about my last product that I have. This is my tried and my true, and I will repurchase this, I suppose, until I die, unless something else works better. But so far, nothing does. So this is it. You know it. You love it. I'm sure, at least. Do I even need to introduce it? This is the Urban Decay All Nighter. I will introduce it for the sake of consistency in the video. But really and truly, this thing does not need an introduction. I don't know if it was like the first setting spray that I ever used, or if it was just, maybe, did it set a trend or something? I feel like it did. I feel like a lot of brands did not have setting sprays, and then Urban Decay came out with their All Nighter, and then suddenly everybody now has a setting spray. So setting spray is a very, 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 very crucial part of my makeup routine. It is crucial. I need it. And so this is the best that I have tried ever, maybe ever, I guess. I've tried lots, but this one's my favorite and will always be my favorite. Yeah, like I said, repurchase till I die. On that same note, the words, brain work, please. The eyeshadow primer. That one, the primer potion. The Urban Decay primer potion. That is also my favorite eye primer. I haven't really tried that many other eye primers, if I'm quite honest, so I don't know if there is something out there that I would like better, but as of right now, it's the only one that I like and use. So Urban Decay has holy grail products for me that I will never not have on hand for my makeup routine. Hopefully nothing ever happens to the brand. I, you know, watch a lot of videos talking about like brands that are sort of old hat or blah, 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 and how, oh, maybe they could someday go out of business or whatever. I hope that wouldn't happen, because there's some things that are a desperate need for me, and I know that they work, and it's just like not worth trying a bunch of other things. So I would be sad if that ever happened. So Urban Decay, I love you. Don't leave me. Don't leave me. Well guys, that's kinda it for me today. I don't have a lot of luxury items in the docket right now just because there's just so many good things that don't cost that much money anymore. So I have been enjoying that a lot more than the luxury stuff, but still with, like I mentioned, like skincare specifically too, like I think it's good to invest, and I think that sometimes luxury skincare does better than some drugstore stuff, but you know, I do think that drugstore is definitely giving luxury stuff a run for their money, and I have found some really good options. I do think that luxury eyeshadow works way better than drugstore eyeshadow, though I have tried some good ones in the past, and actually I should probably try more from the drugstore because that is one area that I definitely have stuck with luxury, you know, instead of drugstore, so I should probably try some more drugstore eyeshadows. And hey, if you're curious about all that, you let me know and maybe I could do a video on that. Might be fun. Anyways, thank you so much for hanging out with me for a little bit there. I hope that you got some recommendations, maybe some new products that look interesting for you to try if you're curious. And I, you know, if you want me to talk about other things, let me know. Reach out. All of my socials are in the description if you want to reach out at all. So I guess that's it. I guess that's it for me today. So thank you so much again for joining me today. I hope you have a very good day, night, morning, evening, wherever, whatever, whenever you are. And until the next one, I'll see ya. Bye.